F-1-A-18, they plan a little trip to plug up all the leaks along the southern border strip. They plan to surprise a man, make a big arrest, cause the president, he told them that they didn't send their best.
They passed some laws, but illegals kept it coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. They gathered them up and started to deport them down to the border and back to Mexico.
They gathered a militia and they named it after ICE. They wanted to be positive, it didn't sound nice. They searched in the churches and the schools and the mall, and the president announced that he was gonna build a wall.
The president made rules, but the courts overturned him. He was still convinced that illegals had to go. He made some threats and that was disconcerting, so they headed for the border and back to Mexico.
You'd think we'd see why we wouldn't want a wall. Those people pay their taxes, $12 billion all in all. They pick the fruit and the veggies from the field. It's pretty clear they end up with the raw end of the deal.
But they spread some lies, try to make them look like bad guys, saying that they're criminals and on the public dole. When it comes to fake news, that one gets the grand prize. Always change reality to fit the current goal.
We chase them to the briars and we chase them to the brambles, but we need someone to blame when our economy is slow. We better face the fact that our thinking is in shambles and our problems aren't coming from a place called Mexico. Now the fruit is hanging in the bushes and the trees, and the farmers are begging for someone to please. Billions of dollars just are rotting on the ground, and the gringos won't do it, not a single worker found.
I wonder what we'll do when they all just stop a-coming. They handle all the jobs that we refuse to do. Best of luck to you if it's a farm you're running, cause the chances are you're never gonna find another crew.
We chase them through the briars and we chase them through the brambles. And why we wanna do that, I guess we'll never know. We better face the fact that our thinking is in shambles, and our problem ain't coming from a place called Mexico.